Hey, what's up guys, and welcome to a new news video on the channel. The Ed Cox retired. On the 27th of May 2021, the Ed Cox announced their retirement. The Team GB Olympians have competed on the HSBC Beta World Tour together since 2013 and have achieved remarkable success throughout the period. With 435 career wins to her name in both mixed and women's doubles, Leeds-born Gabby will look back on her career with great pride. Gabby said, "What an unreal journey the past 15 years have been. I feel incredibly grateful to have had the opportunity to be able to do what I love for so long. I'm extremely proud of what we have achieved and the life lessons badminton has taught me along the way. I've been fortunate to travel the world making many friends along the way. I will forever cherish the magical moments like standing on the podium alongside my husband and celebrating with our team. Finally, I'd like to say a huge thank you for everyone that has supported me throughout my career. It really means a lot and never went unnoticed." Chris added, "My journey in badminton over the past 15 years has been everything and more that I could have ever hoped for as a young boy who fell in love with the sport at such a young age. However, I now feel this is the right time to step away from competing. I've always felt extremely privileged to be able to do something I love for my job, and I leave the sport knowing that I did everything I could to make the most of this opportunity. Badminton has given both Gabby and myself so much. We have so many amazing memories, experienced some unbelievable experiences, met so many incredible people along the way, all this while traveling the world together. The feeling of competing at the very peak of the world level was always my dream, and happily we got to do that for an amazing 10 years. The moment standing on the podium with the gold medal around your neck is undoubtedly a feeling I never forgot and will always look back on them with pride." The Badminton England chief executive Adrian Christie paid tribute to both players. He said, "This is a very sad day for the world of badminton, for Badminton England and Team GB, and also for me personally. Such is the respect we all have for two outstanding players and wonderful people who it has been my privilege to know. I cannot thank Chris and Gabby enough for the pleasure, excitement and memories they have given to so many fans over the years. That incredible Saturday night at the World Championships in London, gold medals at European and Commonwealth Games, the World Tour Finals win, and the brilliant medal at the World Championships in 2017. The executive ends his statement by saying, "I wish Chris and Gabby all the luck and success for the future. Thank you for the amazing memories." Carolina Marin recently just injured herself just ahead of the Olympics. Carolina Marin has suffered an injury in the anterior cruciate ligament of her left knee. She felt some discomfort in her left knee during her routine practice. Doctors later confirmed the injury after some tests. The extent of the injury is not yet known. The injury will be a major setback to the Spaniard with just 2 months until the Olympic Games. It may be noted that the injury in her ACL this time is on her left knee, while the ACL injury which she sustained in 2019 was on her right knee. "I wish Carolina Marin a quick recovery so that she can come back strong and play the Olympics." After a lot of drama, finally it has been decided. The majority has not been completed, which means the 21 point system is here to stay. The 11 point system will not be part of the badminton game for a couple of years at least. "I personally think it's great. It's not good for the game to have so many changes. There have been so many successful other sports like tennis who haven't changed anything and still a lot of people watch it. Badminton doesn't need a change of scoring system, it needs a change of how the matches are presented, you know, everything around the events, like attractions, like playing nice and fun music, etc., but not the scoring change. So I feel very relieved and happy that the scoring system stays at 21 points, since I, as an athlete, am also gonna play tournaments, and I was not looking forward to play tournaments with the 11 point system." Lee Chong-wei about the decision that the 11 point system will not get voted through and failed, jokingly said, "If only they had agreed to the shorter format on Saturday, I would have come out of retirement to play the game again. But seriously, I'm just glad that the world body has put the interest of players first. Why change something when it's already good? Just look at the number of people who watched the final of the 2016 Rio Olympics and the edition before that in London 2012, the three-time Olympic silver medalist said. Brice Levadas had also a very strong sentiment against the change of the scoring system. He posted on social media, "I've known two changing systems in my career and one test. governing institutions want to change again the scoring system. To me, it's a bad idea, and we all know the reason of more money because medias will pay more, or we would be more on life, is just a scam. If our sport keep changing scoring system every 15 years, how can you keep credibility and how can you make your sport bigger? It's a shame that already nowadays we can't compare matches from 2006 to all the ones after that. Now we will change again and lose all comparisons. Culture of badminton is losing big time at this game of changing all the time. I'm sad for badminton and the badminton history. How can you tell the kids that they won't be playing like the stars they used to watch on TV? When I go to teach badminton or when I go to talk about it to different people, most of the time I have to repeat the rules of badminton because it's not very clear for everyone. Now it would just be a nightmare and such a shame for me to tell them that we changed again. All the sport and fitness aspect is just a minor issue and isn't very relevant. Tennis and football who never changed, look how famous they are. It's not a question of lengths either. You can watch TV for 4 hours to watch them really hit the ball for 50 minutes. Badminton is 35 minutes of reaction for a 1.5 hour match and yet people watch tennis. Let's just hope that they will not vote for this new change again. PV Sintu has not been training with Gopi Chand as of lately. PV Sintu has been training separately since February 2021 with coach Park Tae-sang at NSI Stadium, while the rest of the Indian team train at the Gopi Chand Academy. Speaking to Outlook, she said, "I think I'm prepared and I will not miss Gopi Chand Sir in Tokyo. I'm putting in about 5 to 6 hours with Park and Sushitra every day to keep myself ready for the games. Look, as athletes, we have to live in the present. It's good to have change. You get to learn different things from different coaches. At the end of the day, a player has to assimilate and decide what is best for him or her." Fresh new allegations against Li Yongbo are now out. Former Chinese women's singles player Zhu Mi has thrown allegations against former head coach Li Yongbo, saying that she was asked to throw the semi-final match of the 2004 Olympic Games by the controversial coach. Zhu Mi said that Li Yongbo instructed her to deliberately lose the match to teammate Zhang Ning before the semi-finals of the 2004 ASEAN Olympics. Zhang Ning went on to win the gold medal after beating Miao Din in the final. "The coach gave me instructions, we must put the honor of the country first. I've never considered personal interests too much. Of course, I felt very wronged in my heart," she said. She feels that the coach gave her the instructions because she was 4 years younger than Zhang Ning. The result of the 2003 All England final was also decided before the match. She was asked to throw the final against another teammate there, she continued. Not only this, when she left the national team in 2006, it was also under Li Yongbo's interference, she revealed. Zhu Mi said, "It was actually the coach who asked me to retire. I followed the coach's instructions and I retired. Actually, I didn't choose to retire." Though Li Yongbo remains one of the most successful coaches, his career as a coach has been marked with many controversies. In the whole sport, sometimes someone needs to be the bad guy. And of course, I play the role, Li Yongbo. During the 2000 London Olympics, for example, Chinese women's doubles player Wang Xiaoli and Yu Yang were disqualified from the tournament for throwing matches. Wang and Yu deliberately tried to lose to their Korean opponents in the group stage so that they could avoid meeting their teammates in the knockout stage. Li Yongbo said, "As the head coach, I owe an apology to the Chinese badminton supporters and the Chinese TV viewers. The Chinese players have failed to demonstrate the good traditions and fighting spirit of the national team. I'm the one to blame." At the 2000 Sydney Olympics, another women's singles player, Yeo Zhao Ying, has also alleged Li Yongbo that her loss to fellow teammate Gong Chi Chao in the semi-final of the 2000 Sydney Olympics was orchestrated by him. The reason was that her compatriot had a better head-to-head record against the other finalist Camilla Martin. Very strong allegations against Li Yongbo, certainly. What are your thoughts on this? About China throwing so many matches and Li Yongbo allegedly being behind it? Leave your thoughts in the comments down below. Carolina Marin can watch her matches in virtual reality before it really happens. I know it sounds insane, but it's true. Fernanda Rivas came with a special approach. Marin became Rivas' so-called Guinea pig in the experiment. Her coach Rivas knew he could not beat the Chinese in their own game by using the training methods which they used. So he took a different approach. He took the approach of data science. The day before the 2014 World Championships finals against the then reigning Olympic champion Li Chiwei, Rivas and his assistants stayed up until 4 in the morning analyzing games of the opponent. creating video clips, tables and graphs for Carolina Marin. Marin came out victorious in 3 sets after meticulously carrying out the game plan which Rivas came up with. With data science becoming more popular, a lot of companies specializing in collecting and analyzing sports data have emerged. Even though it means shelling out anywhere between 7,000 to 100,000 euros for the services of these companies, he at least does not need to stay awake till 4 AM before Marin's matches. Rivas has had roughly 240,000 games analyzed to date. An average of 50,000 pieces of data is collected from each game. This translates to roughly 12.500 million pieces of data to get valuable analyses from. This type of analysis is known as big data. Big data deals with datasets that are too large or complex to be dealt with by traditional data software. Now combine big data with AI, short for artificial intelligence, and you can achieve things you have never imagined before. This is how Carolina Marin can watch her matches even before it really takes place. From the thousands and thousands of real videos analyzed, matches are recreated in virtual reality for Marin to watch and memorize. So when Marin enters a court, she can almost sense what her opponent will do even before it happens. It is not a certainty, but seeing such pattern in the opponent's game gives a clear winning advantage to Marin. However impressive the power of data science is, it is merely a cog in the wheel in Marin's success. Fernando Rivas says big data can make the difference between a gold and a silver medal, but the key is mental strength. Insane, right? Watching the matches in virtual reality? I mean, I like analyzing my opponent's matches ahead of the game also, but that's what Marin and her coach does is just next level. Certainly plays a part of her amazing success. With that being said, that's it for today's news episode. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, consider giving me a like and subscribing to my channel. I would appreciate that a lot. And with that being said, I see you guys in the next video.